Hello students, today we are going to see the topic steps in value engineering. I am Professor K. Kalidas to handle this lecture for you. So what is meant by value? We have seen already the value of the product is the ratio of utility to the cost. Suppose if I am spending rupees 5 for a pen, does that 5 rupees is good for utilizing or using that particular pen? So that is nothing but the value. Here, value engineering is a technique of applying the value of product analysis at design stage or premature stage. Anyway, the application of value analysis is going to be done. But generally, value analysis is done after the product has been decided and during the manufacturing it has been done. But in value engineering, the analysis has been done at the design stage itself. So if we have some modifications in the design, is it possible for me to reduce the cost? That's what we are going to analyze. So that's something with the value engineering. So what is the steps in value engineering? So there are 8 steps. The first step is preparation or organization. Second, information. Third, function analysis. Fourth, speculation or creativity. Fifth, evaluation. Sixth, development. Seventh, presentation or report. Eighth, implementation and audit. We'll see in detail about all this 8 steps now. So the first step is the preparation or organization. So before designing a particular product, we should clearly understand what is the need of the user, why we have to design that product, and what are the facilities that is required by the user while using that particular product. So we should understand the need. Then we have to go for a survey and study the existence of products with its specifications, looking for similar products in the market and its existence in the market. Why that has been done? If a product of the same kind is available, I have to look for what are the drawbacks of that particular product. I have to make an analysis and I have to implement those drawbacks into my design. So I need not go for the entire design. I can just modify the design according to the available product. Then third one, it is the learning and understanding the product information comparing to the existing product. So as said, we are going to compare the product information which is available in the market. Then a team of design experts is built and they are going to finalize the final design. Then to understand and categorize the functional requirements of the product. You have already seen what is meant by a function. It's nothing but the utility. It has been divided into primary, secondary and tertiary. So for a product, I should define and categorize these functional requirements, which is primary function, which is secondary function, which is tertiary function, and how I am going to concentrate on these functions to establish. So this is nothing but a general preparation of a value engineering process. Step 2 is the information. So to determine the objective of the product and its constraints for production or use, what are the drawbacks? What are the bottlenecks for manufacturing or using a particular product? So that we have to get the information. Then we have to develop a cost model. How much cost will be spent and what will be the rate of return if I have an initial investment cost? So all this has to be established in the cost model of that particular product. then to identify and establish the evaluation criteria or rating for that particular product. So we should have some criteria for analyzing that particular product, and we should rate it, and we have to say at what position does our product lies. Then to prepare a functional analysis system technique diagram to identify when, how, and why the functions are required while using that particular product. So at all the time, my product need not do the same thing. Say for example, mobile phones, all the 24/7 we are not going to speak. But we can use the same mobile phone for other purposes. So we should identify when which functions has to be fulfilled. Step 3 is the functional analysis. So as I said, to understand the various possibilities of obtaining the functional requirements, then to analyze the possibility of imparting the suggestions of the team, and to characterize the product for the specific needs, fulfilling the other requirements. So it is nothing but we are going to judge the functions. Step 4, it is the creativity. Now we have a team of design engineers. So they have a good creativity while making a particular design for a particular product. Now, just we are going to get the idea from the team, irrespective of whether we can implement it or not. Without worrying about the practicality of applications, we are going to get the creativity of the team. Then we should obtain various alternatives of ideas of designing that particular product. Some ideas, while discussion, may merge together, and that idea can be validated in a proper manner. In any point of time, there should be no critics towards the creativity. So just like a river flow, they are going to give some ideas. So it's only an idea generation step by all possible means. Step 5 is the evaluation. Now, this point, we have got so many ideas from the design experts. Now we are going to analyze, criticize, and rank all the alternative of ideas. We are going to compare the pros and cons, that is advantages and disadvantages of all the ideas. Then rank the alternatives based on its practicality and value, etc. Then consult the experts, experienced persons and stakeholders for getting the input whether this design can be implemented or not. Now we evaluate the idea based on the cost, performance, life cycle, etc. So this is the evaluation step. Step 6 is the development. Now prepare a proposal. So you have decided what is your idea of design is for. Now you are going to develop a proposal plan of how to implement that particular idea. So in that proposal, we are going to discuss, okay, this is what is going to be my product, and these are going to be the advantages and disadvantages of implementation and all this. Then we should have some convincing facts to impress the investor. So we should add some convincing factors or facts with respect to the product. Then ultimately, the cost estimation and the value report. Step 7 is going to be the presentation. So the proposal is made. Now we are going to present the final design to the decision makers and the stakeholders. If there is some minor suggestions, then we are going to get that and we are going to implement that for enhancing the idea of implementation. So once everything is completed, we are going to implement the idea, still find some sources of improvement during audits. Once every process is completed, so we are going to implement the final design. So these are the 8 steps. It's very simple. So first, go for an analysis of the function and the requirement of the product. just get the ideas from the creative team, make a ranking, hierarchy of rankings based on value, cost, products, etc. Prepare a proposal by analyzing the various ideas, just present it and implement it. So these are the 8 steps in the value engineering. So in this lecture, we have seen what are the various steps in value engineering process. Thank you.